In this video, we are going to make rhythm doctor in Godot. Nah, I'm just kidding. We're making our very own terminal or command prompt for the Windows users. Oh, and if it sounds like I'm whispering, well, it's because I'm recording this at 3 a.m. in the morning. So, I was actually planning to recreate Rhythm Doctor in Godot when I stumbled upon something interesting, GitHub's GameOff jam. And let me tell you something, this year's theme immediately caught my attention. Now, full disclosure, I jumped into this about 5 days late, so when I saw the theme was secret, I knew I had to participate. This is actually my first game jam this year, so I'm using it as a benchmark to see how far I've come with my game development skills. This is where it gets interesting. I've decided to make this extra challenging for myself. I am going completely solo on this one, working with my, let's say, very limited art skills, and I'm taking on one of the Game of Wild Cards. Speaking of wild cards, the first wild card really caught my eye. Create a game using 4 colors or less. There are other wild cards too, but I am primarily focusing on this one. If time permits, I might look into implementing the others. So, with secrets as my theme and a 4-color limitation, I needed to think strategically about what kind of game would play to my strength. Initially, I considered a text adventure game, but I've already done a tutorial on that. I also thought of a quad-colored platformer inspired by Will You Snail, even a top-down game like Hotline Miami. But here's the thing. I had to be realistic about scope and my solo capabilities. Let's just say my previous attempts at animation have been ceremoniously deleted, and I didn't want to get bogged down with complex mechanics. Then it hit me. Why not create a hacking simulator? And no, it's not just because of my last video was about hacking. This idea actually ticks all our boxes. It fits perfectly with the secrets theme. You're literally trying to access secret files. A terminal interface is a perfect excuse to limit our color palettes. It lets me focus on gameplay and narrative without complex animations. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. I didn't want to do a regular text adventure, so I decided to do one with steroids. Now, I'll be honest, while I have some basic understanding of ethical hacking, I've never really played the hacking simulator before. So I spent some time on itch.io researching different hacking sims to understand the genre better. The game is currently titled Unauthorised, and I'm setting it in the 1960s during the height of the Cold War. While I don't want to reveal too much of the story yet, I can tell you it's going to be narrative heavy. The main objective was to create an authentic simulation of a 1960s terminal. This meant I needed to 1. Create a system for text input and output, 2. Develop a parser that understands player commands, 3. Simulate a complete file system, 4. Create an atmosphere that feels retro and nostalgic. So, let me walk you through what we've built so far. The terminal is case sensitive and processes commands by 1. Splitting input text by white space, 2. Checking if first part is a valid argument, 3. Validating any additional arguments. Here are the current commands you can use. Help shows all available commands. List displays files in current directory. Lost shows current directory. Open open files and folders. Meta checks file metadata. Notes stores and writes notes. find locates files in file system. Clear cleans the terminal display. Back moves up one directory. Shut down quits the game. One cool feature I would like to show you guys is the password system. For example, using openxy, where x is the file and y is the password, enables you to open files with passwords, given that y is the correct password for the file. Files without password use an empty string as the default password. The simulated file system of this game is currently stored in a JSON file. I know it looks a bit messy, but if anyone has suggestions for a better way to store file system data, let me know in the comments. And yes, there might be some hidden commands, like the echo command that I showed earlier, which prints whatever text you give it, but that's just one of many. I'll let you discover the rest when the game releases. Right now, I am still testing the password mechanics for bugs, working on implementing the access command for hidden files, developing the story and puzzles, and adding cryptography elements to the game. If you'd like to see a tutorial on creating a terminal simulation in Godot after the jam, let me know in the comments. This is my first devlog, so I would really appreciate your feedback on how to make this more engaging. Don't forget to join my Discord server, the link is in the description. We're actually trying to hit 1k subscribers before the end of the year, so if you're enjoying this content, consider subscribing. If you'd like to support the channel in other ways, you can find those links in the description as well. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.